So I'm rebuilding my Game Jam game. I've already made a video explaining whole situation and called it a devlog, but it was more like 2 minutes of yap yap yap. To keep it short, 1 year ago I've made a game for a Game Jam, it sucked, and now I'm trying to remake the game using all the knowledge I gained from my ongoing game development research. So I'll point out things that suck and improve them while explaining methodology I used to do it. Is that what I'm supposed to do in the devlog? I don't know, but let's start. Firstly, I created a new project, reorganized the file system, changed some code, and transferred scripts and scenes from the old project. I tried working with the original game project, but it was such a mess that I decided to create a new one. Aside from questionable art decisions, I'll talk about improving visuals in another video, there are some issues with hitboxes and gameplay mechanics which need to be resolved, and also need some polish. So I start with the obvious one, why the hell doesn't this knight get hit? All enemies in my game have two collision boxes, one for collision with surrounding area so that they wouldn't go through walls, and the other one for hitbox, which registers all projectiles and other types of damage player can deal. To distinguish which objects collider should ignore and which it should not, there are collision layers. I have a projectile layer where all projectiles belong and environment layer for the environment. The problem with this collider is that it detects both the projectiles and the environment, and it really should mind its own business and just focus on the environment, ignoring the projectiles completely. And how to fix it? Well, it can literally be fixed with one click. Now let's actually look at the enemy scene. In my game, all characters with HP have health component and hitbox component. Basically, once hitbox component gets hit, it sends signal to health component, which then registers damage and also creates that flash effect. I learned about this component thing from this video, really recommend checking out, and added it to my game without a second thought. Turns out I needed that second thought. Firstly, I actually don't need the hitbox component at all, because health component can fulfill its role itself. Secondly, but scene 3 just makes more sense now. When health component gets hit, it registers damage, that's it, no extra steps needed. Now, you know that feeling when you're learning some new skill and you do something that seems incredibly cool at the time. But after some time, when you got better at this thing you're learning, you look back at your earlier work with this look on your face. Well, that's how I felt looking at the projectile script. When I was making this game, I knew that there will be three types of projectile. Arrow, gun projectile, and homing missile. Gun projectile and arrow basically have the same functionality, move forward, hit target, disappear. Homing missile, on the other hand, would follow the target until it finally hits it, and again disappear. So I thought, well, they're all projectiles, right? That means that I should make one script that would have all projectile types in it. And when I need to add a new projectile to the level, I'll just use the script to handle which projectile I need right now. So every time a projectile was created, I sent required projectile type to the script. Then, depending on which projectile I sent, it adjusted sprite, collider size, and layers, so that player projectiles would hit enemies, but not player, and vice versa. I felt like genius when I've written all of this code, although it's literally crashed the whole project and I didn't have any backups, but I thought it was just some engine bug and not my fault. That's basically one of the key rules of programming which I didn't follow. You shouldn't make a complex script that does everything. Every script should do its job. And if it does too much, you're doing something wrong. If you'll ever find yourself in this situation, lucky for you, I got a solution. So you open this troublesome script, then you press Ctrl A, and then press Backspace. Works all the time. So how did I actually fix it? I've made this pretty simple script for normal projectiles with some export variables, meaning I can adjust some variables directly in the game engine editor without having to change the code. So now you can just create a new scene using this template, change sprite, collider size, collision layer, and get a new projectile easily without any crashes. Then I've made the code for the homing missile and also fixed this weird movement homing missiles had. I honestly don't know why it moves that way, but it's much better now. And to make it even better, I've added some particles for movement and explosion, and it looks much better now. The last thing I wanted to cover is Dash, that just doesn't look right. I want to add this ghosting effect to create a sense of fast movement. The problem is my player character consists of several sprites, and that means I can just copy and paste someone's code to my game, unfortunately. So I've experimented a bit and found the best solution for my game. I've created a player sprite group that has all player sprites, apparently. Then I've made this code. So how does it work? When player starts dashing, a new node is created and added to the level. This node will contain all the sprites that represent player character. It instantly sets node transparency to 0.2 because it looks better and ghostier. Then script goes through every sprite in player sprite group and creates a new sprite for each node in that group with same parameters like texture, z-index and transform. I also create a twin that handles node transparency, and once it's fully transparent, the node is deleted. Then after 0.01 seconds, it checks if dash is already finished, and if that's not the case, script repeats itself. And that results in this ghosty dash effect, which definitely makes it look better. It actually makes me wonder why didn't I add this when I was making the game. But anyway. Well, that's all for now. I'm already pretty happy with some changes I made. But there's still a lot of work to be done. In next devlog, I'll cover the level generation system I've been working on.